Hello everyone and welcome to Gardening with Ben. In this episode we're going to tell you what seeds you can plant in January of 2023. So sit back, relax and enjoy today's episode. We'd film these episodes outside, but it is absolutely freezing and it is raining. So in today's episode, we're going to talk about what seeds and what plants you can plant in January of 2023. And yeah, there's plenty that you can be planting around this time of year, especially during the wet weather, especially good for planting fruit. But obviously if you're planting seeds, you might need heat. So you might need a heated greenhouse or you might need a warm windowsill where it's getting plenty of light. But in this episode, we're going to talk about what vegetables you can plant, what fruit you can plant, and what flowers you can plant. So first off, we're going to be talking about what vegetables you can plant at this time of year. And if you've got an allotment like myself, you will be eager to be starting those seeds off, but sometimes it's best just to wait a little bit of time until it's a bit warmer or the weather's a bit better, because a lot of things do catch up, but some things you do need to plant in January to get good returns. So first up, the first vegetable that you can plant is broad beans. Now you can plant broad beans now or you can plant them in April time. The reason behind a lot of people planting them now is because if you start them off now, they'll be ready to harvest earlier. And because they're ready to harvest earlier is that the black flies won't be around at this time of year. And broad beans can get absolutely inundated with black flies. As you can hear, it is raining. But yeah, the black fly can just swarm your broad beans. They don't do much damage, but they can swarm them. And getting them ready now and growing them now, you can be harvesting them later. And you can either start them off in pots first, or you can start them off in the ground. Usually, I would start them off in pots first because I have trouble with mice and rats and squirrels, and they will come along and pinch all the seeds. Whereas if you start them off in pots, you can grow them to a decent size and then plant them out once they're big enough to handle themselves, and you can add that protection from them. Or obviously, like I say, you can plant them in the ground as long as you make sure they're safe away from the mice, rats and squirrels. So next up is celery. Celery needs to start pretty early, and you need to be getting that growing pretty early to get the harvest at the right time, because it do take a lot of time to get growing and get harvested. And as you can see, it's dripping behind me. We do need to replace the polytunnel skin eventually. But yes, celery, you need to be starting it off pretty much now, and you will need warmth to get them seeds germinated and get them growing. So obviously if you've got a heated greenhouse, perfect, but if not, you'll need to put them on a windowsill to get them warm and get them germinated. But make sure they don't get leggy if they've not got enough light. So it's a situation really. You can either start them off like early March time where you're getting enough light, or you can risk it and give them a try now. Next up is onions. Now if you're wanting onions, you can start them from seed. And I did an experiment a bit back growing some from seed and growing some from set. And the ones from seed actually do better than the ones from set. Again, this year I'm doing both. I'm doing seed and set, so stay tuned to keep an eye on how well they grow. If you're not following me on Facebook and Instagram, make sure you follow me on Them Garden with Ben, and you will be able to keep up to date with how well they're doing. So obviously, again, growing onions from seed, they'll need the warmth to get them germinated. So either in a heated greenhouse or on a nice warm windowsill. And then when they're big enough, then you can obviously plant them out the side in March, April time, when the weather's better. And obviously they are good in cold weather, onions, but I would plant them once they've started growing around March, April time outside. And you can get decent big sized onions from seed, and they're a lot cheaper than obviously buying the sets, and you'll get more seed for your money. So it's up to you, seed or sets. But yes, I'm trying both this year. I've started some off now in January from seed, and then I'll be planting the sets out in March time. Next up is potatoes. Now, we're not planting potatoes now. It's too cold to be planting potatoes, not unless you're starting some off in a polytunnel, in a tub, or in a potato bag. But potatoes, they will start to be on sale now in the garden centres and in the shops. And I've purchased my potatoes. I've gone for Charlotte and another variety, I just can't remember, I think it's Mary's Pike I bought. I've purchased two, and the reason why I purchased them now is because obviously they'll all start selling out soon. But I've purchased them now, and I will be chitting my potatoes. And chitting potatoes means that you'll put them individually into egg boxes or into pots so that they can start to sprout. Now, they need to be somewhere nice and cool, not too hot, not in the dark, but so that they start sending the sprouts out on the potatoes. And that's giving them the head start to get growing. So when you're planting them out around end of March, beginning of April, I always plant my potatoes on Good Friday. Yes, it moves every year, but that is an old gardener's tale. Plant them on Good Friday, and I always stick to that. So I'll be putting them in the pots now, start chipping them, and then I will plant them out on Good Friday in the ground outside. So yes, that is what vegetables you can plant in January. So next up is what fruit can you plant in January. Now, January is obviously a really cold, wet season of the year, but that makes it perfect conditions for planting fruit trees. You don't want to be planting fruit trees in the summer because it's too warm, they won't take, and in the summertime they're concentrating on sending the fruit out, they're not concentrating on growing the roots. And planting them now, you can keep them wet because it'll keep on raining, they'll get the water that they need to get the roots established and get them in the ground, and it will be perfect time. So go to the garden centres, go to the shops, have a look around for the fruit trees and get them planted. In some places you can get them pretty cheap. Now, my fruit trees, I just purchased them from the supermarket and they have done absolutely fantastic down at my allotment. And obviously, if the ground is too hard, take the fruit trees out, put them in some water for a night so that they're drinking the water up and getting started, and then plant them out the day after and you can get them in the ground. But remember, when you're planting your fruit trees, they're there forever until you possibly dig them up, but make sure you plant them where you exactly want them to go. Next up are raspberries. Now again, it's good time to be planting your bushes, your raspberries, stuff like that. And raspberries, there's two varieties. There's autumn variety of raspberry and there's summer fruiting raspberries. Now, I've got both down at my allotment. I've got summer fruiting and I've got autumn fruiting, so that I get constant crop throughout the summer and autumn period. Now, the variety that I do prefer from them both is the autumn variety. They seem to have bigger fruit on them and they seem to produce a lot more raspberries. I don't know why, but autumn raspberries seem to do best down on my allotment. And autumn raspberries, when you're pruning them back at the end of the year, you can prune them right down to the ground and they will grow back with new fruit canes on each year. Now, summer raspberries, you only prune back the ones that haven't had... For summer raspberries, you prune back the ones that have had the fruit on that year. The new growth, what has produced that year, will be the ones that fruit next year. So remember that. Summer fruiting raspberries, you prune back the ones that have had the fruit on, and the ones that have produced new growth is the ones that will fruit next year. Confusing? That's why it's sometimes best to grow the autumn raspberries if you don't want to be confused, because you can just prune them to the ground each year. Next up is rhubarb. Now, rhubarb, again, you can buy rhubarb crowns from garden centres. Now, these are perfect to be putting in the ground now. Again, if the ground is hard, wait until it's a wet day or it's soft and plant them out in the ground now. But the thing is, with rhubarb, you don't want to be picking it in the first year, because the rhubarb crown needs to get established in the ground. It may be tempting when you're seeing the rhubarb growing off the crown, but don't pick it in the first year. It needs to concentrate its energy into growing that crown and getting it established in the soil and producing the rhubarb. Don't pick it till the year after. You can obviously start rhubarb from seed. Now, I've done this in the past and it is really easy. They grow really well. They'll take a few years to get established, so if you're not in a rush for rhubarb, you can start some off from seed. But again, like I said, it'll take them a while to get established. You start them off in the greenhouse in pots, and then you'll plant them out when they're big enough, and they'll take a few years to get growing and get nice and big. So if you wanted rhubarb for your crumbles, get them in the ground now. The crowns are ready for next year. So that is what fruit you can plant in January. So next up are what flowers you can plant in January. There's not many flowers you can plant in January, but there is a few that you can be starting off with. Now, first off are sweet peas. Now, I start my sweet peas off on in a Tupperware box or a piece of kitchen roll, damp piece of kitchen roll. Place all my sweet peas on the kitchen roll. Once they start sprouting, then I plant them up into plant pots. And that is 100% germination, mate. I do really well with that. And as you can see, get an example. Here we have some that we have started already. We're going to be starting a lot more off. We need to look for a lot of sweet peas this year. And then we'll plant these out when it gets warmer, like in March, April time. So yeah, you can start them off now. And I'm just keeping them in a nice, cool polytunnel, because we don't want them growing too fast and too big, too weedy, ready for the year, so perfect in that polytunnel. Next up are snapdragons. These will need heat, they'll need warmth, they'll have very tiny seeds. I've never grown them before, this is my first year growing them, very tiny. So I've put them all in the plant pot, got them all in a nice warm flat and on a windowsill, and then once they're big enough, then I'll bring them down to the polytunnel and we'll separate them all and growing. So next up is lobelia. Lobelia is perfect for your pots, for coverage, for spreading. Perfect, beautiful flower. Again, very, very tiny seed. And yes, if you're wanting to start some lobelia off, now is the perfect time to get that started, ready for them summer pots. And then once they're big enough, again, you'll need to separate them. Might be quite difficult because they're tiny, but separate them up and get them growing, and then they'll be ready for the summer flowering. So that is all the flowers what you can plant in January. So if you've enjoyed this episode, make sure you click that subscribe button to stay up to date with all our videos. We're going to be producing lots of videos this year from down here on the allotment. That is my New Year's resolution, to do lots and lots of videos. And last episode that I did was a tour of my plot, which was for January, so have a look at that one and you'll be able to see what mess it is at the moment. I'm very open and honest about my plot, as you can see the polytunnel's a mess as well behind me. But yes, it will look good when it gets to summertime, trust me, fingers crossed. But yes, stay tuned for all these episodes and how well we're getting on down at the allotment. So until next time, remember, keep smiling, keep gardening, and keep listening to Gardening with Ben.